Welcome to this video on how to simulate infusion cloning with Geneious Prime. Infusion cloning allows the combination of multiple DNA fragments with homologous ends. The infusion enzyme chews back the nucleotides from the three prime ends of the fragments. This creates overlapping homologous ends on the different fragments, which can then anneal together. Addition of DNA polymerase fills in any non-complementary sequences. And finally, DNA ligase seals adjacent nicks. The result of infusion cloning is a scarless joint of multiple DNA sequences. That's a brief overview of infusion cloning. Let's now simulate this process in Geneious. In this example, we will clone a promoter sequence into a vector and have this placed before the EGFP gene. The first step is to prepare your DNA fragments for cloning, such as a vector and an insert. Vectors used in infusion cloning need to be linearized first. To prepare a vector for infusion cloning, identify the region you want to linearize in the sequence. You can either use PCR or a restriction digestion to linearize the vector at the desired site. For the restriction digestion, select the unique restriction site. Then, select Cloning at the top and choose the Digest into Fragments option. In the new window, ensure your desired restriction site is selected and click OK. Alternatively, you can use inverse PCR to linearize your vector. To do this, select your circular vector file and zoom into your desired cloning region. Simply click and drag on the sequence from left to right at the desired site to add a forward primer. Aim for a primer size of around 20 nucleotides and a melting temperature of approximately 60 degrees Celsius. To add the primer, select Add Primer. In the new window, give the primer a name. Ensure the direction is set to forward and click OK. The primer bind annotation will now be visible on the sequence. For the reverse primer, start at the same desired site, but this time move your mouse to the left. You are again aiming for a primer size of around 20 nucleotides and a melting temperature of approximately 60 degrees Celsius. As before, select Add Primer. Give the primer a name, and this time ensure you select the reverse orientation. Before proceeding, make sure you save your file by selecting Save or use the keyboard shortcut. To simulate the PCR to linearize the vector, go to Primers and select Extract PCR Product. In the new window, use the drop-down menus to select the primers you just designed and click OK. The result is a linearized vector. And as well as a linearized vector, you will also require a file containing your insert. Now we're ready to simulate the infusion cloning reaction. To do this, select your linearized vector and the insert files. Then, select Cloning and choose the Infusion Cloning option. In the new window, use the drop-down menu at the top to specify the backbone file. The Infusion Cloning tool automatically ensures a 3' exonuclease is selected for the simulation. By selecting Primer options, you can adjust the desired primer settings. By default, Geneious sets the minimum overhang length when using a single insert to 15 base pairs, or 20 base pairs when using multiple inserts. This is the length of the annealing bases, the complementary sequence part that two neighboring sequences will have in common after the operation. You can also adjust the desired minimum overhang melting temperature in this window. Click the OK once you're happy with the primer settings. Finally, to run the infusion cloning simulation, select Generate Constructs. The final step in the infusion cloning simulation is to analyze the results. After performing the simulation, you will see a series of new files in the document table, a report, final product, and primer sequence files. In the homology assembly report, you will see a text breakdown of the simulation. The hints section lists any manual modifications to the primer sequences, such as the addition of bases. And within the generated primer section of the report, the forward and reverse primer sequences will be listed. The document table also lists each primer created by the simulation as separate files. Finally, you can preview the final plasmid by selecting the InFusion cloning product. Here you can zoom into the sequence to ensure the site's ligated sequences are as expected. You can also mouse scroll over the primer annotations to view the primer characteristics, binding sequence, and extension sequence. And that's how you perform InFusion cloning in Geneious Prime. To learn more, visit Geneious.com.